beats West as the Gamecocks travel to Western Division foe Mississippi to take on a Rebels team coming off one of their biggest wins in the last decade. Welcome to beautiful Oxford on a Saturday afternoon where the Rebels have a new coach, a new attitude, a new quarterback, and perhaps a new outlook after stunning the Florida Gators in the Swamp a week ago. It's the kind of performance Steve Spurrier has been looking for out of his team, and more specifically, his offense. Both these teams have identical 3-2 records. Chances are one of them will go bowling at the end of the year after they were each shut out of the postseason a year ago. The loser may be watching the postseason on TV again, all that making for one of the most important games on the calendar. And with that, we say hello and welcome, Mike Morgan, alongside Brad Moeller. And Brad, without question, both these teams trying to make a statement here today.
Oh, you're right, Mike. Ole Miss trying to prove that last week's win at Florida wasn't a fluke. They could be undefeated this year. They've lost a couple of heartbreakers. For South Carolina, they have the top defense in the nation, but offensively, the Gamecocks are struggling. Only 4 touchdowns in their last 2 games.
A year ago with Arkansas, Houston Nutt had one of the best backfield duos in the history of college football to work with. This year, he's at Oxford, and now he's got a very talented quarterback in Jevon Snead.
Jevon Snead's a good one. He's 3rd in the SEC in yards per game, has 8 touchdowns, also has 8 interceptions, but if you give this kid time, he can light you up.
Well, it took a while, but we finally got to see what Steven Garcia, the redshirt freshman quarterback, could do last week. He led the team in passing and in rushing. He's not going to start today, but Brad, there's a good chance he might finish this.
You're right. Garcia ran for a touchdown, threw for another last week against UAB. Very dangerous. His athleticism makes up for a lot of deficiencies on that offensive line that's given up 17 sacks. Gamecocks just trying to get it in the end zone. They've had to settle for 7 field goals in the last 2 games.
The Rebels have won the last 5 in the series. The Gamecocks try to turn that trend around when we return on Sports South.
Mike Wallace on the return, and he is brought down inside the 25-yard line. The Rebels will take over first down and 10. These two teams have not met since 2004 on homecoming. The Rebels stunning the Gamecocks at Williams-Brice Stadium. That was when Lou Holtz was the head coach. They have not met ever since. Rebels start off I formation. Mike Wallace and Shea Hodge, 2 of the receivers. Eason is the back in the eye. Play action. Snead looking right side, completes the pass and out of bounds at the 45-yard line. First down yardage to Mike Wallace, the senior out of New Orleans, Louisiana. He was 3rd team All-SEC a year ago.
This Ole Miss offense comes out firing against a top-ranked pass defense in the country, and the Gamecocks don't cover it well. A good job of moving the sticks on first down by Ole Miss. And again, if you give Jevon Snead time, he can light you up. He has been known to make some mistakes, however, with those 8 interceptions.
Eason the lone back, Snead out of the gun, quick drop, throws, right flat, complete to Shea Hodge, and that'll be another first down. First pass was for 17, that one is for 10, and the Rebels moving the sticks here early.
And Mike, South Carolina really hasn't seen much of a passing offense the last few weeks. They played a lot of running teams the last few weeks with UAB and Wofford. Before that, they had Georgia. Before that, they had Vanderbilt.
Now McCluster is in the game, and we're going to see a lot of this man, Eason. Cordera Eason right now coming in, their leading rusher, averaging 4.5 yards a carry. Just a couple on that play, but Brad, we're going to see 4 different Rebels get the football in the backfield today.
Yeah, you get a lot of different looks out of Ole Miss. You mentioned Eason, you've got Bolden, you've got Cook and Davis, and then, as you mentioned before, the ever-dangerous McCluster. He's going to catch a lot of passes, he's going to run the ball, they're going to run that wild Rebel formation as well.
Brandon Bolden, now another different tailback in the game. McCluster, this is the Wild Rebel. Little razzle-dazzle and a lot of room on the left side. It's Mike Wallace. Past the 30. takes a dive and is all the way to the 28 of Carolina.
The misdirection by Ole Miss really tying up South Carolina right now. South Carolina defense is a very aggressive defense, but sometimes they hurt themselves with over-pursuing. You look at it here, the Wild Rebel formation, the misdirection. They've got everybody going the other way. Wide open running here for Wallace, and another first down for the Rebels.
Chris Culver on the tackle after an 18-yard gain. McCluster stays in. He's now behind Jevin Snead. Cordera Eason also in the game. Hand off up the middle. And another good pickup for the Rebels. Give them three.
Number 25, Cordera Eason.
That is Cordera Eason before Eric Norwood brings him down.
Yeah, Jasper Brinkley in there as well. He's had kind of a quiet season coming back from that knee injury last year. Like the Gamecocks would like to get him involved early in this defense.
Second down and seven. McCluster at the top of your screen. Snead looking the opposite way. Now flushed out of the pocket. He's going to run to the 20. And then just ball squirts out and goes out of bounds at the 16. That was a live football.
Strange play there. It looked like it just popped out of his hand. He certainly wasn't trying to pass it. He had already crossed the line of scrimmage. And the Rebels catch a break there. They'll bring the ball back, I believe, to where he lost control of it.
Our referee is Mark Curlis. First time we've seen him this year. So that makes it third down and two. The Rebels need the 18 of Carolina. And here's McCluster lining up in that Wild Rebel formation. Mike Wallace, they fake the misdirection. McCluster keeps it himself. McCluster turns the corner and is shoved out of bounds inside the 10. It'll be another first down for the Rebels.
This turns out almost like an option play, which the Gamecocks have seen before, where somebody has to take the quarterback, in this case McCluster, but then someone also has to take the pitchman. Nobody took the quarterback, who in this case is the running back, but it's just assignment football, and Ole Miss executed. The Carolina defense did not.
13-yard game. Give Emmanuel Cook credit for the tackle. Andrew Harris is the receiver at the top of your screen. They go in the eye. Right up the gut and a gaping hole for Cordera Eason and a touchdown for the Rebels.
Well, that was an impressive drive by Ole Miss. They made that look easy, and that's deflating to a very good South Carolina defense. Right up the gut, right through the heart of that Gamecock defense. Ole Miss on the board with six early.
Joshua Sheen is on the field for the extra point, the junior out of Oklahoma City. A perfect 19 of 19 on extra points this year. Kick is on the way, and it is good. So the Rebels, an impressive 8-play, 76-yard drive to take the lead in this one, 7-0. Ole Miss on top. Gamecocks finding themselves in a hole early on. We'll see what Steve Spurrier's offense can do when we return. Rebels out to a 7-0 lead on an impressive 8-play drive, taking just over 3 minutes off the clock, 3:05 to be exact. Culver is the deep man on the kickoff return. He fields it at the 12. Culver slips, now spins out of a tackle and finds some room on the left side. Past the 30 and down to the 32-yard line. A 20-yard return for Chris Culver, who has really picked up his play as a return man this year.
He certainly has. He was a good one last year as well for the Gamecocks. And converted wide receiver playing defense, still returning kicks. Going back to that touchdown drive by Ole Miss, Mike, that was the first touchdown South Carolina has given up in the first quarter all season long. In fact, I believe coming into today's game, South Carolina had only given up 3 points in the first quarter.
There you see your starter at quarterback, Chris Smelly. And in the game in the slot is Kenny McKinley, number 11. Smelly out of the shotgun. As time, fires, complete to Wesley Saunders. Saunders, the tight end, who's been in the doghouse a little bit here lately for his lack of blocking, but he picks up 6 yards right there.
And Mike, anybody who's followed South Carolina this year knows the tight ends are a big part of this offense. Wesley Saunders, the number two tight end. It's his fifth catch of the season. Jared Cook, the starting tight end, very good. He leads the Gamecocks in receptions as well. Look for Smeller, whoever's at quarterback, to look for those tight ends early.
Barnes, McKinley, and Cook trips to the right-hand side for Carolina. Rebels showing a four-man front. Here's Mike Davis trying to find some room behind the left side of that line, but he can't do it. Ashley Palmer, the senior out of Compton, California, delivers the blow, a loss of a yard.
Well, Mike Davis should be rested for the Gamecocks. He sat out last week serving a one-game suspension against UAB. Kind of been a struggle to find that go-to back for South Carolina. They haven't really had a breakaway back. Mike Davis has been the starter most of the year, but other younger guys have played well. Eric Baker, Brian Maddox, and then another senior, Bobby Wallace.
One of the best pass rushers in the SEC, Greg Hardy, is in the game now, working the right spot on the defensive line. Here's a third down and 5. Draw play to Davis and a whole lot of room on the left side. He's all the way out to the 48-yard line. A first down before Jamarca Sanford trips him up.
Big play for the South Carolina Gamecocks, moving the sticks. Didn't want to go three and out. And Gamecocks really haven't had a lot of big plays out of their running game this year. The longest run, I believe, was a Mike Davis 50-yard run. You take a look at it here. It gets a nice hole. Bounces it out to the outside. Good blocking downfield by the tight end as well. But other than the 50-yard run by Davis, I believe the other longest run is by Chris Smelley of 24 yards.
That is the bread and butter running play for Steve Spurrier in this offense. The draw play worked to perfection right there. Barnes and McKinley, bottom of your screen. Smelley pump fake. Now he's going to take it and run. And he'll be tripped up after a gain of 3 by Alan Walker, the sophomore out of Olive Branch, Mississippi, which is where the team stayed last night.
Right, about an hour away from Oxford here last night. And Chris Smelley, not known for his running ability, but he's going to have to be a little bit more mobile. Again, that offensive line has struggled for the Gamecocks. They've given up 17 sacks this season. That's last in the SEC. So Chris Smelley is going to have to be a little bit more mobile against this very good defensive line for Ole Miss.
Kenny McKinley stays in the game. Top of your screen, Bobby Wallace, the senior out of Conway, is the man deep in the eye. Second down, 7 yards to go. Looked like Smelley calling an audible. Here is Wallace. Wallace along the right side. Wallace shifting and making his way just shy of the 40-yard line. Should be a first down before Sanford and Kendrick Lewis bring him down. Nice run there by Bobby Wallace.
And my coach, Steve Spurrier, has been saying what he wants out of his running backs is finding somebody who can make somebody miss. And that's something South Carolina hasn't done much with his running game. Bobby Wallace does it there, picks up a nice gain and another first down.
Kenny McKinley and Mo Brown on the left side. It's Jared Cook flexed out on the right. Davis coming in for Wallace. Smelley out of the shotgun. Smelley looking deep. Down the left corner, it's Mo Brown. And incomplete. Pretty good coverage on the play for Ole Miss. Marche Green had him draped down the field.
And you like to see the Gamecocks at least trying to take a shot downfield. Good coverage down there. Didn't get the safety help until late, so it was one-on-one with Mo Brown, who's one of the faster receivers. Had a big game earlier this year against Georgia, but haven't heard much of him the last couple of games.
Now Joe Hill's in the game for Carolina. Joining McKinley and Cook on the left side. Jason Barnes at the bottom of your screen as you sit, take a look at Chris Smelley. Second down and 10. Smelley, seven-step drop. Flushed out right. Throws. Caught by Barnes. He just lollipopped that one down the near sideline and somehow got it into Jason Barnes.
Jason Barnes was wide open for a very long time. As you take a look at it here, Smelley gets pretty good protection as he rolls a little bit to his right, finds Barnes downfield right near the sideline, just gets it over the head of the defender there, but Barnes did a good job of just sitting down between a couple of defenders in zone coverage.
They're going to review the play. It's a 15-yard hookup, and they're going to make sure he only needs one. 1 foot was in bounds. Jason Barnes, the redshirt freshman out of Charlotte Independence High School. He's got 4 catches coming into this game. Mike Davis, the lone back. Smelley feeds him. Room along the right side, but quickly strung out at the 20. A gain of three for the senior out of Columbia. Ashley Palmer and Kendrick Lewis on the stuff.
Do a good job of pursuing to the football. We've talked about this defensive line for Ole Miss. One of the top defensive lines in the SEC, and that's saying something. South Carolina's defensive line very good as well. They do a good job of stringing things out for the most part. A short gain on first down.
Second down, 7 yards to go. The red zone has been a bit of an issue for this team this year, settling for far too many field goals for Steve Spurrier's liking. Barnes, Hills, and McKinley in at wideout. Smelly looking to the left. That's Hills. Hills on a little, looked like a little out and up move, but the ball not there. He was guarded by Marche Green.
And good coverage there by Green, actually. It's the little bump at the line of scrimmage that prevents that from being a perfectly timed pass.
That is Tyrone Nix, a former game on leading the Rebels defense. And needless to say, Tyrone Nix, Steve Spurrier, familiar with one another. A lot has been made about that going into this ball game. So on third and 7, McKinley, the man in motion. Smelly, out of the shotgun. And a penalty flag drops to the field. The field turf here in Oxford. No grass. This is actually the field turf surface, which you don't see anywhere else in the SEC.
Full snap. Ball start. Number 76. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
That's another false start penalty against the Gamecocks, something that's bothered them all season long. Got to the point after a couple of games this season where Coach Spurrier said he was going to take anybody out who committed a false start penalty.
So a critical penalty now makes it third and 12. Smelly surveys. Barnes and McKinley up top. Cook flexed out to the right. Smelly. Play action. Here comes the blitz, and Smelly is smothered at the 30-yard line. Ole Miss brought the house. A loss of 6 on the play.
Outstanding pressure by the Rebels. They bring it from all sides. Again, very good defensive line. You take a look at it here. They bring some extra as well. Smelly tries to step up, but there's just nowhere to go. Didn't have anybody open and couldn't get rid of it in time. I'm sure Coach Spurrier would like to at least throw it away. It'll be a longer field goal now for Ryan Succop.
So this will be the 10th play of the drive, and it will be a 48-yard field goal attempt by Ryan Succop, the senior out of Hickory. Hammers it, plenty of distance, and it's good. And Carolina is on the board. 10-play drive resulting in a game quarter. The Rebels up 7-3. And Succop, the man who just hit the 48-yard field goal, now with a kickoff here. And that'll send Mike Wallace back to the goal line. Wallace, straight up the middle, past the 25, stacked up at about the 28-yard line where the Rebels will have it. First down and 10. 27-yard return for Mike Wallace.
Mike again for Ryan Succop, the South Carolina kicker, the SEC Special Teams Player of the Week after his 4 field goals last week. Now moves all by himself in second place in school history. Now with 210 career points, he was tied with the great George Rogers, the Heisman Trophy winner, coming into today's game.
Jevin Snead in the game. They will not go Ryle Webel this time, but he does have McCluster in the game. Snead fires near sideline, complete. That is Shea Hodge, who had a huge game against the Florida Gators. Now the officials talking about it, looked like there might have been a little bit of a push off there. They did not throw a flag, but now they're saying, well, they're signaling that he's out of bounds, but now they're saying so Hodge, who got away with a little bit of a push-off anyway, ruled out of bounds. Second and 10. Again, the ball at the 28. Rebels making it look easy on the first drive. Four four-man front. Gamecocks run a stunt. Pass is complete at the 40. That is McCluster. And anytime he gets the ball in his hands, he's a threat to go. Jasper Bringley pummels him to the turf. But Dexter McCluster, who goes all of 5'8", 165 pounds, is one of the most dangerous guys with the football in this league.
It certainly is wide open here. This is an easy pitch and catch and a big play for the Ole Miss Rebels. He can run. He can catch. Leads the team in receptions coming in. Second in receiving yards. He's also third on the team in rushing yards. A big double threat for the Ole Miss Rebels.
Now a heavy dose of McCluster here early. Shea Hodge and Lionel Breaux in the game at receiver for the Rebels. Hand off, that's Eason. And not a whole lot of daylight on the left side. Number Captain Munderland on the tackle.
So Marvin Sapp in there as well. Got into the backfield, couldn't make the tackle in the backfield. Sapp's the backup senior linebacker. Take a look at it here. He kind of forces him to go back inside. A little push from behind. Sapp has played very well. In fact, he's tied for third on the team in tackles coming in. South Carolina defense able to string it out after about a three-yard gain.
Second down and seven for Ole Miss. Rebel offense, very unpredictable. With the exception of the wild Rebel formation, so much of what they do is entirely different from what Houston Nutt did at Arkansas. Great lick there as McCluster caught it. Somehow held on after a big-time hit by Darian Stewart.
And Stewart, the big-time hitter, as you said, comes in also tied for third on the team in tackles. You take a look at it here. Great closing speed. Snead throws it on a rope out there, and does a good job of holding on to it. That was a big hit by Darian Stewart. Another great one in the defensive backfield for the South Carolina Gamecocks, along with Emmanuel Cook.
Six-yard pickup, which sets up a third and two, and here is the Wild Rebel. McCluster gets it, has a ton of moves up the middle, and almost broke that one. Chris Culver will get credit for the tackle. He clicked his heels. Other than that, he would have been off to the races.
Ole Miss got some good blocking up front. In fact, it looked like they got away with a hold here on the end. Falls on top of one of the defensive ends there and falls right on top of him. Kind of horse-collared him. Didn't get the call. It's a big gain for Ole Miss, and they're almost in the red zone once again. South Carolina defense looks a little bit confused.
They'll stay with the Wild Rebel. McCluster, high snap, going to take it himself again. And finally, the Gamecock defense
number 22,
stuffing this one near the line of scrimmage, giving a yard. It's the first time today that Ole Miss hasn't gotten a pretty good chunk of yardage on that formation.
South Carolina's defense is only giving up an average of about 221 yards per game, which again is number one in the nation coming in. But Ole Miss moving the ball at will on their first two possessions here in the first quarter.
Second down, 9 yards to go. Snead completes it to Mike Wallace. And he'll be escorted out of bounds at the 16-yard line. A gain of six on the play. Carlos Thomas making sure he doesn't gain any more than that as he pushes him out of bounds.
Wallace ran a very good route there. Carlos Thomas fell down in his coverage, and that freed Mike Wallace up for the easy catch.
So a big-time third down right here, third and three. Gamecock defense needs a stop. Ole Miss looking for more here. And timeout on the field. The Rebels going to burn a timeout here. 3:21 remaining in the first quarter. A lot of offense thus far. The Rebels leading the Gamecocks 7-3. And right now the Rebels trying to give the fans something to cheer about. Here's a little pitch play to the right side. That's Bolden, a bruising back. 5'11", 220-pound freshman. Picks up 4 yards. Dustin Lindsay brings him to the turf. But it will be a first down.
Very frustrating offense Ole Miss has right here. Again, we talked about all the different weapons. You take a look at it here. The pitch here to Bolden. He's another good one, averaging nearly 6 yards a carry. It's just a sprint to the outside. Gets a little help with a wide receiver block. And it's another first down for Ole Miss.
First and 10. Ball spotted at the 11. Eason is the lone back. He gets it between the tackles. Give him two.
For Ole Miss, number 25,
second and eight.
Vladi
Ajiboy in on the tackle.
Mike, South Carolina's defense obviously has played well all season long, and with the offense sputtering, don't think the Gamecocks can afford to get down by multiple scores. It hasn't been a quick play offense for Coach Steve Spurrier or a big play offense all season long. They can't afford to give up back-to-back touchdowns. They're going to have to make some adjustments defensively, or at least try to hold the Rebels to a field goal attempt here.
Yeah, that's a great point. There's a huge difference between 3 and 7 right now in this spot for the Gamecocks and the Gamecock offense. Sneed rolls out right, finds an open man at the 5. Pushed out of bounds. That's the tight end, Gerald Harris. 6'5", 245-pounder out of Terrell, Texas. Give him 5 yards.
Take a look at it here. They don't go to the tight end very often. He only had 2 catches coming in for 20 yards, but closer to the red zone, they go to the big guy. A short gain, a good sure tackle by the Gamecocks, but big third down here for Ole Miss.
That's 3rd and 4. They can get a first down at the 1, and they're going to go back to the Wild Rebel. McCluster out of the shotgun. That's Wallace in motion. Fakes the handoff, takes it himself, and an easy path to the end zone right up the middle as the Rebels get 6 more.
And terrific blocking once again by the Ole Miss Rebels up front. Cliff Matthews gets into the backfield, but they just steer him out of the way. And it's an easy path up the middle, similar to the first drive. The Rebels take it up the gut to get 6.
You know, you just don't expect a guy that's 165 pounds to continually run right up the middle, but that's what he's doing. Joshua Sheen on for another extra point. And he hammers it home. So put 7 more on the board for the Rebels.
Take a look at it again, coming right at you. Nothing fancy, fakes the handoff right up the gut. A couple of arm tackles, and he's in for 6 more. Rebels in control here. Again, moving the ball at will, both running and throwing it. And again, the South Carolina defense, which has been so good all season long, really struggling. They really haven't forced any negative plays for Ole Miss so far in this game.
Another long run for the Rebels. An 11-play drive puts Ole Miss on top, 14-3. Ole Miss rushing 4. Smelly sets up, fires, got Barnes, caught it! Touchdown! He held on! A helmet popping stick by the Rebel defense. That was Marche Green popping the helmet off of him. But what a catch by the freshman, Jason Barnes.
Jason Barnes with his first touchdown. Had one taken away last week on a penalty. I believe had an offensive penalty call on him. He's shaken up. They're going to help him off the field. But that's a big 6 for the Gamecocks. You take a look at it here. Smelly with protection. The deep drop. Look at the pop there. Pops the helmet off. Barnes able to hold on. And the Gamecocks back in business.
How about that for your first career touchdown? A terrific catch and a great sign of courage to hold on to that football as Barnes reaches pay dirt. The Gamecocks into the end zone on a 6-play, 71-yard drive. Chris Smelly's 10th touchdown pass of the year. But the Gamecocks in striking distance as it's now 14-10. Mike Wallace on the return for the Rebels, a 21-yard return. Ole Miss a pretty good field position at the 32-yard line. Well, so much for a defensive showdown, Brad. Both these teams figuring maybe they could slow down the other offenses. Carolina coming in, the number one defense in the nation. Ole Miss's defense, when they needed it most last week at Florida, they stiffened and came up big. But right now, it's been an offensive showdown as we still have 14 minutes and change to go here in the first half. Sneed out of the shotgun, a little draw play up the middle, and this time Carolina's there. Not much doing for Brandon Bolden. Jasper Brinkley was on one the of the men on the tackle.
Rebels, number 34, Brandon
Ole Miss
Bolden.
Gives you so many different looks. They do a lot of different things. A lot of movement, Brinkley. But the Gamecocks able to eat it up on that play. They're going to need a 3 and out here, though. We talked about neither punter has had to come out for the Gamecocks or Ole Miss today.
6 plays, 71 yards on the scoring drive. Jason Barnes, his first career touchdown reception. McCluster's in the game, but Sneed is under center at quarterback. Play action. Looking left side. Under hot pursuit. That ball's on the ground. It's a loose ball picked up by Carolina. That's Nathan Pepper, and Pepper is into the end zone. Nathan Pepper with his second career touchdown, and the Gamecocks take the lead.
Unbelievable. The last time we saw Nathan Pepper do that, it was against South Carolina State a year ago. He was injured on the play, injured his knee, and had to sit out the rest of the season. He's okay on this one, probably needs a little oxygen. He's going to head back to the sideline. The Gamecocks with their first lead of the day.
The extra point, number 14.
Nothing better than seeing a 292-pound defensive lineman run down the field.
Nathan Pepper out of Greenville, South Carolina. They're still showing the replay on that big, gigantic replay screen that they have in the end zone that Ryan Succop is kicking to right now. Succa hammers another one home. Carolina with its first lead of the ball game, 17-14 on a defensive touchdown. Nathan Pepper taking it to the end zone for his second career touchdown.
For South Carolina, number 41, Jordan Lindsey. First and 10 from the 14.
Well, Brad, we expected a lot of different possibilities in this game, but already 31 points on the board. I don't know if we expected that.
No, not exactly with this defense for South Carolina. We knew Ole Miss could move the football, but South Carolina's defense providing a spark now. And Ole Miss back to the run here. They've ran the ball effectively so far. A big stop there for South Carolina on first down.
With a second down and 8. Bolden is behind Jevin Sneed. Gamecocks sending 5. Sneed has all day. Throws back the opposite way. And wide open Brandon Bolden, who came out of the backfield, will catch it for the touchdown. Looked like a little wheel route. And Ole Miss worked it to perfection.
It was a beautifully designed play by the Rebels. They fake to the left to begin with, roll out to the right. You've got two receivers in the pattern on the right side, and then the delay, Bolden wide open down the far sideline for 6.
24 yards on the hookup, and Ole Miss is back on top. Sheen on for the extra point. Put it on the board. Ole Miss now leading it 21-17. As we go to break, we'll take another look. The Ole Miss touchdown from Jevin Sneed. Justin Sparks is their kickoff specialist. A pretty good leg sends Culver back to the end zone. He's going to take it out. Culver, 20. And pushed out of bounds past the 25. And at about the 26-yard line. That is Ellis Johnson, the man in the middle. He's got the number one ranked defense in America coming into this game. But right now his defense being tested by this Ole Miss offense, which is dynamic to say the least. The scoring drive for the Rebels, 6 plays. That's not the right one. We'll give you the right one in a second. 8 plays, 65 yards, 3 minutes and 43 seconds, a 24-yard touchdown grab by Brandon Bolden. Mike Davis, the lone back, he's out in a pass route here. Smelly going deep, and Mo Brown turns back on the ball and makes a great catch, guarded by Vaughn, but Mo Brown twisting his body and making a terrific play on the pass thrown by Smelly.
Mo Brown second on the Gamecocks in receptions, coming in, leading the Gamecocks in receiving yards. Take a look at it here. Makes the adjustment on the pass. Smelly trying to buy some time when he rolls out, and Brown makes a great adjustment, comes back for the football. Gamecock wide receivers have made a couple of plays for their quarterbacks today. That's got to give Chris Smelly a little confidence.
Now, Mo Brown had that terrific game against Georgia, caught seven passes, 130 yards. He's kind of disappeared since then. They're waiting to see Mo Brown be more active again. Empty backfield, five wides. Here's Mo Brown on the receiver screen. He's got some room. 25, spins out of a tackle and gets all the way to the 20-yard line of Ole Miss, where Sanford brings him down. But Mo Brown is heating up. Two big pass receptions by Mo Brown. That one going for 20.
And give his fellow receiving mates some credit there for some downfield blocks. This is the place South Carolina likes to run, the little receiver screen, usually with one other receiver out there. This time they had two receivers out there specifically to block. As you take a look at it here, you got Mike Davis, and I believe Kenny McKinley got the block initially. That frees up Mo Brown for big yardage.
Mo Brown with 53 yards in two consecutive receptions. Smelly's starting to get into a rhythm here. 7 out of 13 now for the day. Smelly on the play action, rolling out, looking for Freddie Brown. Instead, will go to Davis, and he's double covered. They were trying to get Freddie Brown involved there over the middle, but Freddie Brown was covered as well. Give the Ole Miss secondary credit on that play.
Yeah, exactly. Freddie Brown, the slant specialist for South Carolina. That's what they were running over the middle, but good coverage. Smelly didn't force it in there. Instead, just threw it out of bounds and lives to play another day. Smelly showing he's a little more mobile today, rolling out of the pocket. We haven't seen a lot of these designed rollouts for Smelly most of the year, but it's buying himself a little more time.
Yeah, it was a good-looking play in terms of just everybody doing what they're supposed to do. Sometimes the defense just has it covered. Second down and 10, Smelly from the gun. Smelly intended for Wesley Saunders, who caught a pass earlier, but Alan Walker reading that one all the way.
Wesley Saunders, I'm not sure if that ball was actually tipped away or if Saunders turned his head upfield too quickly. Either way, drops incomplete, and it's another big third down for South Carolina. As you take a look at it, Smelly over the top, and I think Saunders should have caught that one. They've turned his head upfield a little too quick.
Well, this sets up a third and 10. Gamecocks, 3 out of 5 on third down conversions. Timeout called with the play clock ticking down. Chris Smelly says, let's think about this, let's talk it over. And he'll do so with Steve Spurrier. 4:46 to go in the first half. The Gamecocks trailing 21-17. It's been a high-scoring first half. DeMarco in motion. Smelly looking as nobody somehow gets out of trouble and does a terrific job just to stay in field goal range, getting to the 20. Ashley Palmer getting a big paw on the legs of Chris Smelly. But that could have been disastrous.
Exactly, Mike, and give Ole Miss credit once again for putting a lot of pressure on Chris Smelly, but give him a lot of credit for avoiding the big sack. That's probably the best run for no gain you'll see out of Chris Smelly. Take a look at here. Gets out of two tackles. There's a third, and able to fall head right about at the line of scrimmage.
Ryan Suckup is 11 out of 13 on the year. This is from 38. He's got the distance, but he missed it wide right. Wide right, a rare miss inside of 40 yards for Ryan Suckup. Dexter McCluster, a junior out of Largo, Florida, leading the team in receptions coming in, second in yardage. He can run the ball, had 175 yards rushing coming in. He was averaging 7 yards a carry.
Yeah, he's a little bit do everything and picks up a nice gain on first down thanks to a great block from his fullback, Jason Cook, the senior from Sewanee, Georgia.
Marvin Sapp checks in defensively to give Jasper Brinkley a breather here as the pass is caught at the 30 by Mike Wallace. And he's immediately wrestled down by Stoney Woodson. Woodson, a senior out of Tampa, Florida. Six career interceptions for Stoney Woodson.
Gamecocks giving up a little bit of a cushion there. A little bit surprised when it was second and short. They give a big cushion. He's able to pick up the first down.
Ole Miss taking its time here. Their perfect world would be a long, time-consuming drive, put some points on the board, and not give it back to Carolina. Gamecocks, Norwood coming free and sacks Devin Sneed at the 25 like a runaway locomotive. Eric Norwood racing in. Sneed had no chance.
And Norwood picks up his second sack, gives him 15 for his career. All SEC last year was Norwood. You take a look at it here. Nobody touched him. It's never going to get easier for Eric Norwood. He's a great player on his own, but you can't help him like that.
And 17.
A loss of seven on the play. Second down and 17. Here's Eason. Picks up 2-3 yards.
Cordero Eason, the ball carrier.
He's Darian Stewart filling in. He's defensive backs for South Carolina. Darian Stewart, who plays at the spur position. Also, Emmanuel Cook, the strong safety, do a great job of stuffing the run. They're two of the top tacklers for the Gamecocks.
Now you've got a third down and 13. Ole Miss awfully good on third down, 6 out of 7. Sneed out of the gun. Gamecocks rushing 4 and the pass is dropped by Mike Wallace. And the Rebels will punt it away with a minute 39 to go. And for Carolina, we've got a chance to do some damage here on what could be the final drive of the game.
And again, South Carolina has moved the football well on almost every possession. They've come up short. Once, of course, on the missed field goal, they've had to punt once as well.
Captain Munderland back to receive the Rob Park punt. Key thing to keep in mind here, Gamecocks have no timeouts left. Maybe a go for the block here. Gamecocks they got the punt rush on, but can't get a whole lot of rush going. And Munderland's going to have to back up all the way to 21. Penalty flag on the play. Munderland going the wrong way. Now puts it in forward and gets out to the 27-yard line, but we'll find out what that penalty flag's all about.
A lot of pushing and shoving away from the football. Again, these two going at it like longtime rivals.
The flag is at the 40-yard line.
During the kick, holding number 5, receiving team. Penalty 10 yards into the kick, first down.
That was a 58-yard punt, the holding penalty on Thomas. So all of a sudden now, field position goes from pretty good to awful as they mark it off all the way to the 11-yard line.
Yeah, and Mike, now you have to get real conservative in your play calling here, maybe just try to get out of the first half only trailing by 4.
Again, no timeouts for Carolina. The Rebels don't have any timeouts either. Not very often you see 6 timeouts called in a first half of a football game, but that's been the case thus far today. And again, can't stress this enough. This is such a huge game for both of these teams. Both teams shut out of the postseason last year, and a win today would put somebody in very good position. Bobby Wallace is in the backfield, gets the carry. Wallace is stacked up at around the 13. Kendrick Lewis in on the stop.
And it looks like both teams are going to be content maybe just to run out this half. As you said, can't stop the clock either way. Wallace didn't really try to make anyone miss there, just ran up the back of one of his blockers, keeping both arms around the football.
3 yards by Wallace there, makes it 2nd and 7. Davis coming back in. Spurrier going with a lot of veterans today. Davis gets it. Spin move. Across. across the 15 and down to 17. Craig Hardy, the second team All-American from a year ago with a tackle there. He's actually still been trying to recover from an injury in the offseason. They've been working him back in. He's actually listed second team, but we'll see him out there a lot, number 86.
That's what's been amazing about this Ole Miss team. They've had a chance to win every game, even with some bang-ups on their defensive line.
It's third down and three here. The play clock is at 12, game clock 19, 7 second differential. Neither team can stop the clock as Davis is cut down by Greg Hardy. And that will likely be the final play of the half. And it will indeed be the last play of half number one. And a very entertaining half, particularly if you like offense. A number of good drives. Gamecocks putting a couple of touchdowns on the board. Ole Miss finding the end zone three times. Our score at the half, Ole Miss 21, Carolina 17. Second half action getting underway here from Vaught-Hemingway Stadium in Oxford. Again, the Rebels leading at 21-17. Culver going to take the kickoff from the end zone. Culver running sideways and goes down with a penalty flag as well. And then the ball pops out. The ball popping out toward the end of the play, a scrum, and now a late penalty flag throw. So we've got what probably amounts to an illegal block and then a personal foul here. Meanwhile, the Gamecocks do recover the Culver fumble, and it's a good thing that could have been disastrous. And the official's going to have to sort this one out.
So Carolina will have decent field position. They actually put the ball just past the 20-yard line, near the 21, as we take another look at what happened at the end of this play. And you see the ball coming out there. Sinclair, it looks like, recovered the fumble. Did not see the personal foul. Penalty flag was thrown late. Well, now that we got that squared away, Gamecocks will try to move the football. There's McKinley, caught at the 25 and out to the 35-yard line before being brought down by Tony Fine. Kenny McKinley with his first catch since the Vanderbilt game.
Consecutive games
now with a reception for Kenny McKinley. First down and 10 from the 35. Davis and DeMarco in the backfield. There's Jason Barnes with another catch. Barnes across the 40 and out of bounds at the 43, a gain of 7.
Barnes, of course, had the big touchdown in the first half. Got not goofy, but he's back in there.
Ball will be placed at the 43-yard line. Second and about 2.
You see Kenny McKinley, there was all kinds of questions. Would he be able to go? How effective would he be? The hamstring, 80-90%. But so far, he's been out there for a number of plays and makes his first catch in nearly a month. Mike Davis burrowing his way for a couple.
On the tackle for the Rebels.
Right near the first down marker, it'll depend on the spot. Ted Laurent on the stop for the Rebels, and it will be a first down.
And Mike, this is a key drive for the Gamecocks. As you said, they were able to answer a lot of drives in the first half, but need to get off to a good start here in the second half, especially after starting deep in their own end.
Barnes and McKinley in the game on first down. Smelly hands it off to Davis, who gets a yard. Ashley Palmer trips him up.
25, Mike Davis. On the tackle for the Rebels, number 11, Ashley Palmer.
Mike Davis has had a tough time getting going. In fact, all the Gamecock running backs have struggled for positive yards here. Today, Bobby Walls had a decent first half, 3 carries, 21 yards, but Mike Davis held to under 3 yards a carry in the first half and off to a slow start here in the second half.
Rushing yards thus far today, Mississippi. Most of those coming in the first quarter and most of them on the Wild Rebel formation. Smelly flushed out, looking downfield, nobody's open, and Wisely tucks it and runs.
Tony Fine was there to escort him out of bounds. A little pickup there of 2 yards. So it'll be second down and 8 for this Gamecock offense, which has played pretty well today. Keep in mind, a missed field goal and another scoring opportunity. Of course, one of the touchdowns was defensive. Nathan Pepper on a fumble recovery. But overall, Carolina has moved the ball well today. McKinley and Barnes to the left. Mo Brown and Jared Cook is on the right side. That's McKinley in motion. This is 3rd down and 5. 3rd and 5 for Smelly and company, and the whistles will blow it dead. Could be a delay of game.
And Mike, once again. Once again, I think the crowd had a little something to do with that, as Chris Smelly couldn't hear the coaches waving their arms, yelling out, trying to tell him to get the play off, and he was about 2 seconds late.
45, 3rd down and 10 yards to go.
So 3rd down and 10 now. Normally a passing situation, although they got a draw to work pretty well in the first quarter on 3rd and long. Smelly, 7-step drop, fires far sideline. Did Barnes catch that? He did, but it was out of bounds. Still a good grab by Jason Barnes, who all of a sudden is becoming the go-to target for Chris Smelly today. Cassius Vaughn was on the coverage. Give Barnes now 4 catches for 58 yards. Great call by the officials looking at that replay. And again, they're using what you just saw. This is our camera work that they're taking a look at. And they see that left foot.
Yeah, right there, chose as a catch. And you mentioned 4 catches, 58 yards. That's what he had all season long coming in at 4 catches for 58 yards. He's doubled that here today.
So a nice job, even though it took a good amount of time to go ahead and get it right. And the Gamecocks will have it 1st down and 10. They measured it. And it is going to be 1st and 10 from the Ole Miss 45. So a big call right there. And the Carolina drive continues. Smelly, quick drop, fires complete near the 40. Forward progress will give Kenny McKinley a 5-yard gain.
Good to see Kenny McKinley getting involved in the offense for South Carolina. As we said, he's missed so much playing time. And he's a playmaker for South Carolina. Not that he's going to make an 80-yard catch or outrun everybody, but he catches everything that's thrown to him. He's pretty good after the catch as well. The Gamecocks have been looking for a leader on offense, and it's good to have Kenny McKinley back in there.
2nd and 5. Receiver screen. Jason Barnes has got the hot hand. He's wrestled down at the 36 by Jamarcus Sanford, who's been a busy guy today. Sanford, the senior out of Batesville, Mississippi. He was 4th in the SEC last year with over 8.5 tackles a game. That play doesn't look like much, but what it does, it gives you 4 yards and sets up a 3rd and 1.
This is the play we saw in the first half. Gamecocks got big yards out. 2 receivers out there. Mike Davis, one of them. Kenny McKinley, the other, to throw blocks. The problem was there was 3 defenders out there, only 2 blockers.
This has been a problem spot for this offense. 3rd down and short. 3rd and less than a yard. Davis in the eye. Smelly going to keep it himself. He'll dive forward, and he should have it easily.
And that's the play the Gamecocks usually run in 3rd and short or even 4th and short, is let Smelly just take it over the center, Garrett Anderson.
So the drive will continue to go here.
1st and 10.
Tell you what, this is the best looking the Gamecock offense has been in a while. It's the 10th play coming up on this drive. We've seen a couple of double-digit drives for this team thus far today. They've avoided the big mistake on offense. They've made a couple of big plays, and they're moving the football well. Smelly in trouble. Backside rush and throws the interception at the 30. Lamar Brumfield. And that's the kind of ball that Chris Smelly wants to have back.
Yeah, exactly. Just getting ready to say, as we're making the comments, the Gamecocks haven't shot themselves in the foot with the big turnover. Well, they just did it there as Chris Smelly put right between the numbers of the defender. That's an easy pick there. Obviously, he didn't see him, but that's a mistake that has haunted Chris Smelly this season. He'll look so good for so long and make the one play like that, and that cost him. Had a pretty nearly perfect first half, but the long drive goes for naught. As you take a look at it here, he steps up in the pocket, feels the pressure behind him, and there's just no way you can make that pass.
Just got to throw that one out of bounds or maybe see what you can get on the ground. And Chris Velli and the Gamecocks turn it over. He was looking for Jared Cook.
He's looking for Cook, but he stared him down all the way. He's rolling out, and he's got a backside rush on him. Just a bad decision all around for Chris Smelly. The Rebels will take over on the first turnover by Carolina today. Rebels, first and 10, 29-yard line. Hand off, right side. Nothing doing for Cordera Eason. Marvin Sapp stacks him up.
Talking about Marvin Sapp here earlier. Z coach Steve Spurrier there, obviously not happy with the turnover by the Gamecocks. Sapp, a big part of this South Carolina defense, the backup linebacker to Jasper Brinkley. He's in there usually in passing situations, but also good at stuffing the run.
Second down, call at 9. Eason stays in a tailback. That's Marvin Sapp playing middle linebacker. Pass play out to McCluster. Makes one man miss. Now he's reversing field. If he gets a block, this could be a lot of trouble. 40, 50, 40, and stepped out of bounds at the 35. He stepped out of bounds at the 35-yard line, but a heck of a play by Dexter McCluster, 35 yards.
He does that all on his own. That play should have been strung out probably for a loss, and South Carolina didn't wrap up. McCluster, dangerous as a receiver and a running back. You get a look at both here. Makes a nice catch. There's the missed tackle. You don't see that often. And then just outruns everybody. Even the fast defensive backs of the Gamecocks can't catch up to him. Steps out of bounds here on the sideline, but gets a nice train of blockers as he's going down the near sideline.
Now back to the bigger tailback, Eason, who is upended.
Number 25,
Akeem Auguste in on that tackle, cutting him down.
That previous play to McCluster looks like he could set something up as well, because it may have been a lateral. It was almost looked like it was behind it. It wasn't a forward pass. That's a possibility of McCluster chucking it as well. You mentioned he can run, he can catch, and he can also throw it.
Second and 7. Sneed. Going down the sideline, and there's a penalty flag on Carlos Thomas. Mike Wallace got tied up with Thomas. Looked like he might have just gotten beat on the play, Brad, and did what he could to keep him from going behind him.
Yeah, exactly. And that pass was actually behind him. If Thomas doesn't mess with him, he's probably going to fall incomplete anyway, but he gets his arms all wrapped up in him. And I don't think Thomas even got his head around. Never saw the pass coming. Carlos Thomas will sometimes get picked on in that South Carolina secondary. He's been in and out of the lineup over the last couple of years. He's a good defender, but sometimes has his moments, and has a moment there.
Pass interference on the defense. Penalty of the first down at the spot of foul.
You take a look at it here. Here comes the throw. Receiver tries to stop, come back and get it. He had Thomas maybe beat by a step going deep. The pass was behind him. Might have said that pass was uncatchable, but he did hold him up.
And they go back to the Wild Rebel. McCluster. In the shotgun, going to take it himself up the middle, and he'll fall forward for a gain of about 4, maybe 3. Marvin Sapp on another tackle. McCluster is just an amazing athlete, 5'8", 165 pounds. In high school, he was the All-Suncoast Player of the Year. Played a number of sports. He wasn't just a good football player. He was a great basketball player and track star as well.
He's tied for the 8th in the SEC and receiving receptions per game, almost 4 per ball game. But he said he can do so much as a running back and a receiver. He creates a lot of mismatches with the defense.
Brandon Bolden, who caught a touchdown earlier, is in the game. Sneed rolling out, tries to hit the tight end in the flat, can't do it.
Erwin Norwood just tattooed Jevin Sneed, drove him to the turf after he tossed it away. Norwood had a sack earlier, almost had a second one.
Akeem Auguste was on the coverage. Carlos Thomas out of this game after the interference call.
Saw the pressure there by Norwood. Sneed just had to throw it away to avoid the sack.
Sneed now 13 out of 17, 188 yards and 1 touchdown. Bolden at
tailback, McCluster at receiver. Third down and eight. It's caught, and that'll be a first down for McCluster. Now the ball pops out. Carolina's bringing it back. Past midfield and all the way down to the 42-yard line. That is Emmanuel Cook. That is Emmanuel Cook on the fumble with a long return. Everybody just kind of gave up on the play. 55 yards on the return by Emmanuel Cook. Davis and DeMarco comprise the backfield. Davis has got some room on the right side. Davis upended near the 30, and Mike Davis will have a first down. Kendrick Lewis cut him down, but a big pickup, 11 yards for the senior out of Columbia.
One of the longer runs on the day for the South Carolina running backs. Look at the block from the fullback, Patrick DeMarco. Comes up there, upends the defender, knocks him down. That opens up the hole for Davis, and he's not touched till he's 10 yards downfield.
You know, it should come as no surprise that turnovers have been a huge factor in this game. Both these teams losing to Vanderbilt earlier in the year, and in both those situations, turnovers killed them. Absolutely killed them. Snelly in trouble and brought down near the 40, a loss of about 10. Alan Walker spins him like a top and brings him to the turf.
Second sack for Alan Walker this season. The pocket collapses around Smelly, and he's just unable to get rid of it. Probably got to get rid of it a lot sooner here. Take a look at it here. Tries to step up, and the protection breaks down. Nothing Smelly can do now. And it's a big loss for South Carolina.
They'll give him forward progress to the 38, so a loss of 8 on the play. Makes it second down and 18. Empty backfield. Looks for Davis in the flat, has him, 30, 25. Davis still churning those legs all the way to the 21. Not too far from the first down marker, which is at the 20.
Well, even though that was a reception, that's something Coach Steve Spurrier, of course, we talked about earlier, was looking from his running backs, the ability to make somebody miss. As a receiver here, Davis makes the first guy miss, picks up some nice yards after the catch. You take a look at it. Here comes the first guy. No, sir. Second guy able to spin away, pick up a couple extra yards.
17 yards on the play. Sets up a third and one. Going to be another quarterback sneak. Nope. Going to give it to Davis up the middle. And again, this team really struggles when handing off
Mike Davis is the
on short
here.
Yardage. From here, it looks like he's got it.
Tony Pine was on the tackle for the Rebels.
Well, we've seen South Carolina go with the quarterback sneak in the situation often. A little surprised they didn't over there with Chris Smelly up over center. There wasn't anybody over the center, yeah. Garrett Anderson. If he just goes, pushes the center up the behind a little bit, he's got at least a yard with no problem.
I noticed the same thing. Nobody over the center on that play. Ole Miss was almost saying, go ahead, take it if you want. As they provide the measurement here. Oh, that's about as close as it gets, isn't it? By maybe a half of a link.
First and 10, South Carolina.
And Gotts will take it, whether it's somebody's talking about 20. The left foot, right foot. Well, that was a left big toe, right big toe.
That's right. So the ball on the 20. Gamecocks trailing it, 21-17. Jared Cook is at the bottom of your screen. Davis gets it. Davis pushed back. Bounces off like a pinball. Make that Bobby Wallace before going down. And that'll be a loss on the play.
There's that good pressure up front by the defensive line from Ole Miss. As there was just nowhere for him to go. As Wallace takes the handoff, runs right into the back, I think, of one of his blockers. And this is one of the defenders. As the Rebels busted that one up early.
Bobby Wallace staying in the game. That's probably the difference. Bobby Wallace, he's not going to break tackles. He's the more elusive of the backs. Second down and 14. McKinley in the game. Smelly going left side. Complete to Jason Barnes. And there is a bond formulating here between Chris Smelly and Jason Barnes.
Going to
be short of the first down, but
those two right now are on the same page.
And this is a timing route. He's got to deliver as Barnes is into his break. There it is. He makes his break. There it is on the sideline. Two defenders there. It's Smelly hits the mark, and the Gamecocks now in a third and short.
Big third down from South Carolina, trailing by four.
Third down and four. Barnes now, six catches, 70 yards.
Career highs for the freshman.
Bobby Wallace is the lone back. And crisscross action. Freeman makes the catch. That is the backup tight end, Larry Freeman. If he keeps his footing, that's a touchdown. This is a really well-designed play.
And Chris Nelly does a good job just to get this ball off. He was under pressure, had to move up. If he's not under pressure, if he's able to throw this off his back foot or at least settling his feet, yeah, this is a touchdown. Look at here. Has to throw it off balance, throws it a little high, makes a nice adjustment. It'll be fourth down, just a little bit short. Looks like South Carolina's going to go for it.
Fourth and inches. Smelly under center. Oh, you snap it now. You got it easy. They do. Oh, wait a minute. A timeout might have been called. Ole Miss looked confused. Smelly barking out the signals. And going to take it himself on the left side, and he's got it easily.
Quarterback
running down,
sneak
go
Chris
with the
Smelly.
Quarterback sneak because that's the best short yardage play this team has.
Yeah, Chris Smelly certainly has that play down. Always gets a good push from his center, Garrett Anderson, the junior from Irmo, South Carolina. More importantly, he knows how to keep low, not get himself hit up high, and able to get those short yards when the Gamecocks need it.
And goal for South Carolina.
You've got Anderson, Meredith, and King, the left side of that line, and right now, that's where the push is. Jason Barnes in the game, bottom of your screen. He's had the hot hand. Davis trying to pick his way through tacklers, always churning those legs and always falling forward.
Carry,
just shy of the five.
Mike Davis for South Carolina.
Dustin Malzahn, the tackle, senior out of Orlando for the Rebels.
Again, when you have trouble running the football, this is where it becomes dangerous for South Carolina because it certainly changes your options. South Carolina, of course, would like to be able to run it in here, but they haven't been able to do anything consistently the last few ball games on the ground, especially inside the 20.
Second down and six. Smelly going up top. Barnes, he got it. Touchdown, Carolina. Jason Barnes with a coming out party today. His second touchdown, beating Marche Green.
Marche Green was all over him. Thought there might have been a penalty if that ball wouldn't catch. No flag either way. It's 6 points for the Gamecocks. And Chris Smelly does a good job of putting out the football only where Barnes can catch it. If you take a look at it, just put some air underneath it. Defender Green never turns around, and another nice catch for Barnes, making it look easy.
Green goes 5'9", Barnes 6'4". The fade worked to perfection, and the Gamecocks have recaptured the lead, 24-21. What a game here in Oxford. Gamecocks finding the offense, which has been evasive for most of this year, but all of a sudden Carolina has found it and found it in a big way today. Another long, successful scoring drive, 10 plays, 42 yards, 5 minutes following the turnover, and Jason Barnes, who came in with just four career catches, no touchdowns, he's got two now on the day. Mike Wallace is going to return the kickoff from Ryan Succop. And he is spun down at the 23-yard line.
Number two, Mike Wallace.
And all of a sudden, this stadium has become quite quiet as Yvonne Banag, who's had some passport issues of all things, makes the special teams tackle.
Now it's up to the South Carolina defense to give themselves some more momentum as well, as both teams have moved the football throughout the game, but the defense has caused some turnovers late.
Well, total yards for this Ole Miss offense. The Ole Miss offense has stalled here in the second half, not to mention the turnovers. There's Brandon Bolden, who caught the touchdown pass earlier.
Brandon Bolden is
They've got a large stable of backs. We've seen Bolden. We've seen Eason. Dexter McCluster. We haven't even mentioned Enrique Davis, who's a talented freshman that they had. They've got a lot of guys that can run the football.
And that's what makes this team so scary, is because they have so many guys who can do things with the football, running and receiving, they're not going to get tired. They're not going to get 25 carries a game.
Second down and three. It's Bolden again. And he falls forward. He'll have the
first down, a pickup of five.
Patrick Baldwin is the ball carrier.
South Carolina defense was on its heels, especially in the first quarter. You take a look at it here, and they found Ole Miss has some room up the middle all day long. Remember, their two touchdown runs in the first half were right up the gut.
You know, I'm surprised they haven't run behind their All-American left tackle, Michael Orrmore. Most of these runs have come up the middle or to the right side, like this one right here. And he's got some room on the sideline as Brandon Bolden turns the corner and has first down yardage before Munnerlyn shoves him out of bounds. A 13-yard pickup.
I tell you what, the Rebels also getting some great downfield blocking from their wide receivers. Lionel Bro, number 21, with a good block. Late down there, at least sustaining a block. Look at the hole here. Avoids a couple of tacklers, and there's Bro engaged with Captain Munnerlyn. Is keeping Munnerlyn from coming up to support the run.
Bolden will stay in at tailback. Bolden fights his way for a couple of tough yards. It'll be second and eight. Clifton Gathers, the sophomore out of Georgetown, on the tackle.
Looking ahead for both these teams, it never gets any easier in the SEC. Of course, for Ole Miss, I believe they have a week off, and they get to play at Alabama. That should be a good one.
And that'll bring the third quarter to a close. Another entertaining 15 minutes. We got ourselves a white knuckle here. Might be coming down to the wire. Gamecocks back on top, 24-21 here from Oxford. Gamecocks with a second down and two. Mike Davis in the eye, gets it, big hole up the middle, spin move, and brought down at the 30-yard line by Sanford, who's racking up a high tackle total, but a gain of 12 for Mike Davis.
Well, we called out this offensive line early in the ball game, as again, they had struggled with the running game. They must have hurt us because they opened up a nice hole, and they've done a nice job on this drive. Remember, this started deep in their own end, right around the 5-yard line, and they've been able to find some holes here as of late.
And you got to like the balance. They've been running the ball, throwing the ball well. A lot of different personnel getting involved. Smelly out of the shotgun. Looking deep. He's got McKinley. What a catch by Kenny McKinley, reaching back in traffic between two blue jerseys, and he is inside the five.
Have I mentioned they've missed Kenny McKinley? What a play. You said it. He had to reach back for that one. Smelly does a good job of throwing that ball before McKinley even makes his cut here. It's the only place he can put it. It's his second option, it looks like. Looks left, looks right, and McKinley comes back and gets it, able to hold on as the Rebels trying to strip it away.
This is not easy to do. Look at that. He's falling down, reaching back. He knows he's going to take the hit. What a play by Kenny McKinley. First and goal from the three. Davis wrapped up. That's going to be a loss. Lamar Brumfield, the junior out of Linwood, California, with the tackle.
This is where it gets a little bit tougher in your play selection. You've only got 5 yards to work with. Obviously, you can't do much in the passing game as far as running a lot of different patterns. Gamecocks were running the ball pretty well. Now it gets a little tougher the closer you get in.
Davis will stay in the game at tailback. McKinley and Mo Brown are the receivers. They're working the far side. Smelly settles in, fires, incomplete. That play looked a little bit off. They might have been trying Mo Brown on a crossing route, but it was a very dangerous pass.
Yeah, McKinley and Brown crossed. I don't know if McKinley was actually trying to set a pick for Mo Brown to allow him to get around to the top of the screen over the far side of the field. Obviously, it didn't work out. Big third down for South Carolina, and Ole Miss defensively, they'd like to hold him to a field goal. That way, the Rebels would still have a chance to take the lead on the next possession.
Huge play right here, third and goal from the four. Brown and McKinley, top of your screen. Joe Hill's at the bottom. Smelly looks right. He's running, in trouble, throws to the end zone. Touchdown! Touchdown, Joe Hills! Joe Hills with his first career touchdown. And the Gamecocks extend the lead.
Well,
give credit to Chris Smelly not giving up on the play. Again, not the most fleet of foot, but he's able to buy himself a little time. Rolling out to his right, the Rebels looked like they only rushed three initially, but they were about to get to him. And Smelly showed some patience, able to fire it in there for six.
Has Chris Smelly ever played a better game in a Gamecock uniform? I don't think so. He has been terrific today with the exception of one mistake. And Suckup kicks it off. Back to return. Mike Wallace going to take it out of the end zone. He's got a wedge on the left side. That's where he's going. And he falls down to the 25-yard line.
Mike Wallace on the return for the Rebels to the 25.
A 25-yard return. We look at that drive summary, and it is impressive. 11 plays, 95 yards, 4 minutes, 39 seconds off the clock, culminated by the Hills 4-yard touchdown reception, the first one for that young man out of Palmetto, Florida. That might be the drive of the year for this offense, Brad.
Exactly. Chris Smelly with three touchdown passes, I believe matches a career high, had three in the game at North Carolina last season.
Sneed working out of the gun. And we might see Ole Miss throwing quite a bit the rest of the way, trying to hit McCluster there. McCluster going in, Sneed throwing out, incomplete.
First 300-yard game for Chris Smelly. There's the three touchdowns. Yeah, on that last play, McCluster was open on the play, but you get good pressure from Eric Norwood, and Jevin Sneed threw a little behind his receiver.
That is career numbers on a career day. Sometimes stats don't tell the whole story. Chris Smelly, this to me is without question the best game he has had in a Gamecock uniform. Rebels trying to get back into this one. Sneed in trouble, improvising. 30, and he is smothered by Marvin Sapp there. Marvin Sapp, the senior out of Jacksonville, Florida, second cousin of Warren Sapp. He's been mostly a backup in his career. He's never been quite good enough to stay in the starting lineup, but bottom line is the guy does make tackles when he's out there.
He certainly has. As we said earlier, Sapp tied for third on the team in tackles coming in as you look at Smelly again, and he knows he's still got some work to do. The Gamecocks with the lead, hoping his defense can help him out here with under 8 minutes to play.
I mean, it's got to feel doubly good for Smelly. The talk for weeks on end now has been about Steven Garcia, and that only escalated last week. But right now, Chris Smelly has recaptured this offense as Marvin Sapp reading another play and providing another tackle.
Jevin Sneed, shuttle pass complete to number 34.
It's got to be close if it's short. Be interesting to see what Ole Miss dials up here.
I think it's short by about a yard.
Yep.
Fourth and one. Clock ticking away. I think Houston Nutt's going to go for it.
Yeah, I think so, too. The way South Carolina has moved the ball the second half, maybe he thinks he might not get it back.
Massive substitutions for Carolina. Fourth down and a yard. They need the 35. Bolden is the back. He's to the left of Jevin Sneed, the quarterback. Sneed's looking to throw. And the quick slant, they get it. The coverage wasn't bad, but McCluster, a hard guy to cover. He's so small and slippery. Just throw it low, and the 5'8", 165-pounder hauls it in.
Well, you've got to put the ball in the best player on the field's hands, and that's Dexter McCluster. Two men on him. He's still able to get it. And good pass there by Jevin Sneed to pick up the first down.
Stoney Woodson was on the coverage. First down and 10, Rebels. Sneed completes it. 40, broken tackle. Pushed out of bounds at the 49 is Mike Wallace.
Mike Wallace has been busy, as we said, third leading receiver coming in, both in receptions and yardage, but he's been busy as well. Made the first man miss and picks up another first down. Take a look at it here. Sneed's getting some time. The Gamecocks come on a stunt. He gets away from Captain Munerlin. Don't see that too often. Munerlin, pretty good in coverage, pretty good tackler. Couldn't bring him down there.
Remember that the new rules, the clock is still ticking, even though he did go out of bounds. It won't stop in those situations again until we're under 2 minutes to go, as Lionel Bro makes the grab there. Pretty much going away from the running game here on out.
Gamecocks almost looked like they were in a little bit of a free bet there, as Carlos Thomas was a good 15 yards away from Lionel Bro.
What a day for Emmanuel Cook. 13 more tackles for the strong safety.
Leading tackler for the Gamecocks, supports the run so well.
Sneed looking deep, and that would have been six.
Hodge, who had the huge game against Florida a week ago, had a step on Woodson. I was surprised Snead didn't put more air under this ball.
Yeah, and they've got one-on-one coverage. It's what they want. Look downfield, looks left, looks right, got a step, just got a hand on it, maybe did. I believe it was Darian Stewart. But Ole Miss got what they wanted. They had one-on-one coverage going down the far sideline.
You lob that ball up, and there's not a whole lot Stewart can do to stop it as Hodge had him beat. Third and three. A little draw play, and that should be enough for the first down. Brandon Bolden on the carry. Bolden had 55 yards rushing in that win over Florida. That win over the Gators, by the way, in the Swamp. That's the first time Ole Miss has won a game away from home against a top five team since 1977 when they beat Notre Dame in Jackson. This is why they warn people, beware of the letdown week. There's a wide open receiver, the 20, and a huge hit by Auguste. My goodness, he absolutely laid the wood to Lionel Breaux. We've seen some receivers take some pops and hold on to the football here today.
Well, the Gamecocks celebrating the big hit and are wondering if it was actually caught or not.
Well, now they might be saying incomplete. They're ruling it incomplete. Now, the fans booing. They thought he held on to it long enough. The ruling on the field's incomplete. We'll take another look in a sec, but first, second down and 10. And the throw is complete for the first down. That is Shea Hodge. Take a listen to the hit by Akeem Auguste. Huge hit by the freshman, jarring the ball loose, but the Rebels still have it, first and 10. Snead, buying time. Snead has the ball deflected from behind. It's incomplete. Snead got real cozy in that pocket.
Oh, the Gamecocks getting some pressure, but not able to get to Snead. He does a good job of stepping up and stepping around. Cliff Matthews in there as well. Gamecocks were a little late getting some defenders
on that play.
But Snead able to buy some time, couldn't find anybody open. Looking here, there's the pressure, can't get to him, and then just at the last minute and knock it loose.
That's Jordan Lindsey knocking it away at the last second. Snead now 19 of 28, 235 yards. On second down, receiver screen, he's looking to throw it. Nobody's open, he's got to run now. It's a block on the outside by Snead, and all that does is get him back to the line of scrimmage. But that play well defended by the Gamecocks secondary.
It certainly was. Houston not doing a great job of calling some plays. They saw the Rebels get a touchdown on a delay earlier. You take a look at it here. It's one-on-one coverage passing here. You knew right away this was going to be a pass. It was set up. Doesn't sell it really well. Man coverage down the field and nowhere to go with it.
So with 4.5 minutes left to play in the ball game, the Gamecocks up by 10, 31 to 21, our score. Critical third down and 11, you'd have to say four down territory, or would you? I mean, you need two scores anyway. You've got a pretty good kicker in Joshua Sheen, who has hit a long of 47 this year. So you don't have to necessarily go for it if you're Ole Miss, if you miss it on this particular play. Third and 11. Snead, all kinds of, somehow gets out of it. Pass complete at the 25 and down to the 20. That's Lionel Breaux. And now if you're Houston Nutt, you've got a very difficult decision to make.
Yeah, I think you got to kick the three here. It's a two-possession game. Nice pickup, though. It makes it a little bit easier for your place kicker, Joshua Sheen. And that's what they're going to do.
So Sheen, as I mentioned, a long of 47 on the year. And this is a 38-yarder. He's 6 of 7 on the season. Snap and the hold are good. The kick is on the way. Perfect. And it's a one-possession game with 3:48 to play. 31-24, our score in the Gamecocks in the lead. Justin Sparks will kick it off for the Rebels. No onside kick. He's going deep.
Culver is going to let it bounce out of bounds, and that's a huge penalty right there. It'll be great field position for Carolina.
A big mistake there. Obviously, you don't want to give up the big return, but you got to keep it in play. That's a break for the Gamecocks.
So the ball will be spotted.
On the kicking team, well replaced at the 40-yard line.
The ball will be spotted at the 40-yard line. It used to be the 35. They changed that rule a couple years ago. So now you get it all the way at your own 40.
Now, if you're South Carolina, you want two hands on the football, try to move the sticks at least once. Again, Ole Miss with just one timeout remaining.
Smelly, Davis, McKinley, all the veterans in there now. And we'll see if Carolina can move the chains here. Ole Miss, time is a factor with 3:48 to play. Hand off to Davis, right side, he goes nowhere.
On the carry,
Ashley Palmer on the tackle.
South Carolina, Mike Davis.
A little tougher here for South Carolina, obviously, because you know you're going to run the football. You get a little conservative with how you run, two hands on the football, and at least you'd like to think that for South Carolina. Ole Miss playing run all the way.
There's Tyrone Nix, the former Gamecock defensive coordinator, now with the Rebels. And the Gamecock offense has picked his defense apart for most of the day. Showing pass, working out of the gun, fires toward the corner. Cook on the catch at the Ole Miss 45. And that will give the Gamecocks another set of downs.
Stops the clock, but what a gutsy call by Coach Steve Spurrier. Jared Cook goes up and gets it. Take a look at it. Smelly's got good time here. They come late on the blitz. They rush five. Smelly able to get it up to the big man. Cook keeps a foot in bounds, and the Gamecocks move the sticks once again.
And keep in mind, it only stops the clock temporarily. The new rules in college football, so now you can milk some more clock. You've got eight on the play clock. Smelly sees that, takes his time. Now the snap. Davis on the carry. Davis spins his way into a couple of yards.
The ball carrier, number
25, it'll be second and eight. Marche Green will get credit for the tackle as we near the two-minute mark of this football game. Again, the Gamecocks have lost five consecutive to the Ole Miss Rebels. Haven't won here in Oxford since the 70s. But a chance to turn that whole thing around and perhaps turn this season around.
And more importantly, South Carolina looking for its first SEC win since last year. They've lost six straight SEC games, 0-2, coming in with the losses to Vanderbilt and Georgia. Remember, they had that slide at the end of last year.
DeMarco and Davis in the backfield on second down. It's Davis. Davis picking his way through tacklers. He's shy by about a yard of the first down marker. Palmer, another tackle. Now that is the offensive line coach, John Hunt, and he has been under a ton of heat, really, for a number of years now. But you got to give his offensive line credit, Brad. They have pushed guys around. They have given Smelly time to throw. The offensive line has had a heck of a game for this Carolina team. A minute 48 remaining. Gamecocks up by a touchdown. Critical third down and one here. Davis, the deep back. Tight formation. Smelly trying to take it himself. Second effort might have gotten it. He got stacked up behind the right side of that line. Was kind of stuck in neutral there, and then on the second effort, falling forward, and that might be the difference.
I guess, see where they give him the spot. Needed to get right at the 35. This may be decided by a chain link. Take a look at Smelly. Has had success running up the gut. But they get a good push by the Ole Miss defensive line, able to fall forward there. Looked like the ball was a little bit further across the 35. They pulled it back closer to the 36.
Boy, is it going to be any closer than this? Wow.
Fourth and one.
Well, what do you do here?
Well, they didn't get it there. Do you run the same play?
Yeah, I mean, a field goal puts it away, but you always run the risk of a block.
Yeah,
a punt does you no good.
That's a very long field goal at this point. You do have a good kicker, Ryan Suckup. I think you go for it here.
Fourth down They'll hand it off to Davis, and I don't know. This looked just like the play that Ole Miss had against Tim Tebow in Florida. On fourth and short, it looks like they got it done again.
Yeah, that one, I think he may have lost a little yardage. He needed to get across, looked like just across the 35. He didn't get it. Again, the defensive line for Ole Miss gets the push two plays in a row.
Well, if the marker hasn't changed, this is going to be Ole Miss football. Where they have it spotted. And there you have it. Ole Miss is still alive. A minute 21 remaining. The Rebels have no timeouts left. They need a touchdown, which would be 65 yards.
Bring out the cliches about a game of inches. It certainly was in those last two plays.
McCluster is in the game at receiver. Now, we have had an interesting one today. Mississippi looked unstoppable on their first couple of drives, 14-3 after one quarter. Then the Gamecocks responding. Two touchdowns in the second quarter, including a defensive score by Nathan Pepper. Ole Miss having the lead at the half. But in this second half, the Gamecock offense outplaying Ole Miss. Two touchdowns, and the Gamecock defense has stiffened, holding the Rebels offense to just 3 points in this game. First and ten is Snead leads the troops to the line. Snead under pressure, throws high, and incomplete. Eason was over there in the flat, but Munerlin in coverage.
It's good pressure from Jordan Lindsay of the Gamecocks, and looked like he may have been held a little bit, got pushed from behind, and he one that forces Snead to throw that one away.
Shea Hodge, awfully dangerous. He is at the top. Mike Wallace also in the game. Four wide formation. Snead has time. Fires toward the corner. It's picked off by Carlos Thomas. And that'll do it. Carlos Thomas with his sixth career interception. And the Gamecocks are going to pull off a victory in Oxford for the first time since the 1970s.
Second interception of the season for Carlos Thomas. Read it well, and Jevin Snead never really looks him off. Drops back. He's eyeballing the receiver all the way. Puts a little too much air underneath it. Thomas gets a great jump on it. It's an easy pick. And South Carolina is about a minute away from getting their first SEC win in exactly a year. Last SEC win was against Kentucky 1 year ago today.
1974 was the last time a Gamecock team came here and won. The Rebels had won five in a row in the series. Carlos Thomas, sometimes he's the hero, sometimes he's the GOAT, but he's got the play that'll end this game and give the Gamecocks a much-needed SEC victory, as Carolina now will just take a couple of knees. The Rebels can't do anything about it. There it is. Last Gamecock win in Oxford back in October of 1974.
Mike, this just lives right up to the series now. Going into this game, 10 of the last 11 games between these two teams were decided by a touchdown or less, and it's had a touchdown right now.
Victory formation. Smelly takes it in. And that should be the final play of the game. Carolina has come to Oxford and will go away with a victory in hand. A big one at that. Will this be the one that turns this offense around and maybe gives that man a memorable season for the Gamecocks? 31-24, your final score. And we'll be back from Oxford in just a moment.